Brothers and sisters, this beautiful deen of Islam, the Sharia Allah given to us, is not only some kind of physical and external kind of cleanliness and purification we need to do. We need to have our clothes clean when we come to pray. We need to our body is clean and it is pure. That's true. This is the physical one. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted spiritually we'll be clean as well. Our heart should be the clean, clean heart. Our heart should be clean. Clean from what? In the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked, Ya Rasulullah, what kind of people are very liked by Allah, most liked by Allah? He said, the one whose heart is clean from other people, where there is no animosity, hostility, hatred, and grudge, jealousy against other people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, that day nobody will get salvation in Akhirah except illa man atallaha biqalbin salim. The one who came to Allah to meet Allah with a pure heart, clean heart. That heart, but there is no chance for the hatred, animosity, hostility, and jealousy to enter, to stay. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, indeed, shaitan became hopeless in Al-Jazeera al-Arabiya, in Arab Peninsula, the main Arab land, that there will be shirk there, shaitan will be worshipped there. He is hopeless of that. But he's not hopeless from another thing, that is to make Muslims' relatives, the close people, are turning against each other, the hatred, the jealousy, the grudge are between them. This is another big tool of shaitan. If he is hopeless from shirk, he'll bring this one to destroy our deen. How it is destroy our deen? Another hadith said, should I tell you what is a, ألا أخبركم بأفضل من درجة الصيام والصلاة والصدقة؟ قالوا بلى. قال إصلاح ذات البين فإن فساد ذات البين هو الحالقة. Should I inform you most rewardful action than the siyam, the nafal fasting, nafal salah, and giving sadaqah, charity, more than these ibadah, something, should I inform you? Yes, of course, Ya Rasulullah. Then he said, Islahu dhatil bayn, to correct between the people who became apart from each other, to correct between them, to mediate between them, to make them brothers again, to make them, they are coming together again. Because fasadu dhatil bayn, to destroy the relationship between the people, to cut it off, is the huwal halika, it is the halika, it is the blade. The blade is not, why you use the blade? Sharp, for the shaving the hair. But this blade, cutting the relationship, this is a blade who cuts deen, tahliqu deen, which shaves the deen, takes away the deen. So to mediate, to help people, we can hear sometimes brothers and brothers are not talking, siblings are not talking to each other, husband, wife is gone two different directions, not talking to each other, separated. Business partners, silly issues, again, cutting off the relationship from each other. To mediate between them, to correct their relationship again, to bring it back again, very rewardful, more rewardful than your nafal sadaqah, your nafal fasting, nafal salah. We need to do this. Many people are suffering for this kind of cutting the relationship. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam guided us. Don't cut relationship between you. Don't look for the fault, having a list of the fault of the brother behind him, what mistake he does, having a list of that. Don't create hatred against each other. Don't be jealous against each other. Akunu ibadullahi ikhwana. Rather be Allah's servants, brothers. This brotherly relationship. Wala yahillu li muslimin yahdura akhahu fawqa thalath. It is not halal, not allowed for a Muslim to boycott his brother, not talking to him more than 3 days. Yes, if he hurts you so much, he hurted you so much, he hurt you so much, you can bear it. Allah has given you at least 3 days. Take these 3 days offer. More than that, Allah said, no, now come back to talk. Not halal anymore. Fourth day you see him, you talk. At least give salam. This could be talking. At least give salam. Another hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لا يحل لمسلم أن يهجر أخاه فوق ثلاث فمن هجر فوق ثلاث فمات دخل النار. It is not halal, not allowed for a Muslim to boycott his brother more than 3 days, not talking to him, abandon him, boycotted him more than 3 days. If he does and did not correct before he dies in that situation, he will be entering Jahannam. Many of us, you may find here in the audience ourselves, could not talk to somebody of my clothes. Something happened, more than 3 days, gone weeks, gone months, gone even years. And some of people even died with that situation. Ya Rab, what is their situation now? Another hadith, man hajra akhahu sanatan fahuwa ka safke damihi. Whoever boycotts his brother a year, 1 year, not talking to him. It is a sin, it is a crime like murdering him, like killing him. If he commit murder, can you imagine the sin? Not talking 1 year to one of your brother or sister or relative or friend, boycotting him for 1 year like committing murder. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يجتمع في جوف عبد الإيمان والحسد. Never come together two things in the heart of the servant. Two things cannot coexist together. They cannot coexist. One is al-iman, other one is al-hasad, jealousy, envy. It should be a place of one here. Two cannot have together, cannot coexist. If there is hasad, jealousy, then iman is gone, out. Such a dangerous matter. Good news for those who forgives each other. Even though he was hurt, not more than 3 days, they try to talk, they try to solve the problem, sort it out. Good news for them. If somebody is not doing, there is no good news for them. Another hadith, تُعْرَضُ الْآمَانُ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمِ إِثْنَيْنِ وَخَمِيسِ فَيَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْيَوْمِ لِكُلِّ امْرِئٍ لَا يُشْرِكُ بِاللَّهِ شَيْئًا إِلَّا امْرَأً كَانَتْ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ أَخِيهِ شَحْنًا فَيَقُولُ اتركوا هذين حتى يصطلحا. Our deeds are presented to Allah twice a week, Monday and Thursday, presented to Allah by angels. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees our sin. He also sees our salah. He also sees our tawbah and istighfar and zikr. So he forgives many of the sins. Except the one did shirk, he doesn't do tawbah, Allah doesn't forgive the shirk. Except the shirk, many other sins Allah forgive. MashaAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is very kind and merciful for us. But then he said to the angels, wait for two persons who have this bad relationship, cut off the relationship, turned against each other, hostile to each other, not talking to each other, wait, don't forgive for them. Don't erase their sins until they sort out their problem. If they sort out, then forgive. Omit their sin. If they don't, leave their sins there. You want to be forgiven? We also us wanted to be forgiven by Allah every Thursday and every Monday. That's why the Nafal fasting is very rewardful in those 2 days. So if we, all of us know, sometime we have this kind of relationship happen within us, let us, everybody of us, look where I am falling to this hadith today. Where is my relationship with anybody? Did I stop, cut off the relationship, boycotted anybody? Let us correct him and do tawbah and istighfar to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayat wa dhikr al-hakim wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'il al-muslimin min kulli dhanb. فاستغفر واتوب إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، عباد الله، اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وعليكم الجماعة، فإن يد الله مع الجماعة، ومن شد شد في النار. وصلوا على البشير النذير، إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد. أرض اللهم عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون، أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي، وعن سائر أصحاب نبيك محمد أجمعين، وعن الذين يتبعونهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك وإحسانك يا رب العالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها، أنت خير من زكاها، أنت وليها ومولاها. اللهم اغفر المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات والأحياء منهم والأموات، يا مجيب الدعوات برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم يا رب المستنصرين، اللهم يا رب المستضعفين، انصر إخوان المستضعفين في كل مكان. اللهم انصرهم بنصرك المبين. اللهم احفظهم بحفظك المتين. اللهم أهلك أعداءك أعداء الدين الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون أولياءك. اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر. اللهم أنزل عليهم بأسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين. عباد الله، اتقوا الله واذكروه يذكركم، واشكروه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وأقم الصلاة.